Continue with, first of all, good afternoon, students, and we'll continue with. Chapter 9 of history, that is women, caste, and reform. A lot of noise is coming, just a minute. Okay. So we have last one topic left with this chapter, the Singh Sabha movement. This is the only topic we are left with. Singh Sabha movement. Okay. So basically, if you see, this was reform organization of Sikh. Reform organizations of Sikh. Okay. And it was formed at Amritsar. Amritsar in 1873. Okay. Now, what did this Singh Sabha movement? What happened in this organization? So, the Sabha sought to free Sikhism from superstitions, traditions, caste distinctions, and practices seen by them as non-Sikh. Also, they promoted education among the Sikhs, often combining modern institution with Sikh teachings. Okay. Now, the Singh Sabha movement, basically this was the reform organization of Sikhs. Okay. And it was formed at Amritsar in 1873. Now, the Sabha sought to free Sikhism from superstition, caste distinction, and practices seen by them as non-Sikh. So, what they did, basically, there was superstition, many kind of rituals or what you say, the things, superstition is basically Andhvishwas in Hindi, okay? So that kind of superstition, which was not good for the society, those kind of things were removed by this organization. Now the caste distinction, which was there, so that was also removed. Now practices, there were some practices which people were doing, and that was considered as non-Sikh practice. Like if you have... okay, there was a Khalsa group. Okay, so this Khalsa group, they were basically the warrior class people. Okay, now why this Sikh people made this warrior class group? So what happened? The English, the British were bringing missionaries and all, right? So they were doing the religion change. They were forcing the people to change their religion, right? So in that case, what happened? These people thought, no, this is whatever is happening, that is happening wrong. And some of the Sikh people, they act like warriors, like they used to keep kripan and all, and they used to fight. They used to fight for the Sikh people. So they were called Khalsa group. Understood? So they were basically the warrior class group. Now, if you say they used to fight and all, they had some different kind of things, like they used to keep kripan and all. So what happened, many of the people found these things are the non-Sikhism practice. Okay, so those to remove all these things and make them understand that they are also part of Sikh religion. These Sabha was working. Understood? Now, if you see, they promoted education among the Sikhs, often combining modern institution with Sikh teachings. So what they did, basically, they have not left whatever they had. Okay, reform doesn't mean that you totally change your things. That is not reform. Reform means whatever is happening wrong, whatever is whatever social evils are there, okay, in the society, whatever evils are there, that you need to remove. The bad things which is there, that you need to remove. That is basically reform. Reform doesn't mean that what you change your culture, you change your tradition. That is not reform. So you keep your traditional values with you, but whatever harmful things are there in the society, which is not beneficial for anyone, which is harming the lives of people, that thing should be removed, right? So that is basically reform. So that is what this group did. They kept their traditional values, and also they went towards the modern education. Okay, in many of the madrasas also, if you see, this happened that the people, like if we read about Sayyid Ahmad Khan, right? So he worked for Muslim community. Now, if you see, he also did the same thing. He also went towards the modern education, right? So if you see what these people did, they kept their traditional values. They also taught the Sikhism. Okay, they also taught their own culture and tradition, but with that, they moved towards the modern education. Understood? So there was a combination of modern education with traditional values. Okay. Next is Khalsa schools and college were started in Punjab. Thank you. and there was Khalsa College in Amritsar. In 1892. Okay. So here we end the chapter. Okay. Is there any question from this chapter? Otherwise, we'll start the next one. Any question from this chapter? Anyone? Reply fast. No, we cannot just sit and think whole day that we have question or not. Okay, no question. So we'll move towards next one. Okay. So okay, we have already started one chapter during winter vacation. That chapter 4 of geography. Right, minerals and what resources, that chapter, power resources, minerals and power resources was the chapter we started during vacation. And like what are minerals, what are resources, how extraction is done of the mineral, those all things we have already discussed in that video. So to refresh yourself, just watch that video today and I will be continuing the next part of that chapter. So I am ending this Zoom meeting and I am creating one new one because this will end in between the class. Understood? So I'm ending this meeting and I am just sending you another link. Just join that one. Fine.